everyone, how are you all? I hope all of you are doing absolutely fine. Okay, who am I? My name is Anubha Gaur, your chemistry master teacher at Vedantu. And why we are here? Because it's Tuesday. Tuesday means it's chemistry time, everyone. And as I know, most of you are going through your midterms and some of you are already done with your midterms. So I have made a series, that is spring series. I hope all of you have watched that series. So I have covered chemical reactions and equations as well as acids, bases and salts. So in today's class, that is the part of Umang series, which we are running very early. So I think aap midterm session pehle dekhoge. I have covered so much of important questions that is going to help you out in your midterms. And this is an Umang session so that we can bring Umang to your life. And that means, you know, we are trying to help you in, you know, the concepts which is there in the chapter. So this is conceptual based chapter. So let's start. Acids, bases and salts, that is part 2. Before that, you can even watch part 1. So, sabse requested jo topic tha aapka, wo I have already covered that. This is the second season or second part. Let's just start with it. What we are going to cover in this chapter, let's just see it right now. What you can see on your screen? Kya cover karne wale hain hum? Chemical properties of acids and bases. बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट्स को इसमें बहुत सारी मुश्किल आती है व्हाट एग्जैक्टली यू नो एसिड इज व्हाट एग्जैक्टली अ बेस इज जनरल डेफिनेशन ऑल ऑफ यू नो बट ऑल ऑफ यू डोंट नो इन डिटेल व्हाट एग्जैक्टली एन एसिड एंड बेस आई विल ट्राई टू इंक्लूड अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट हॉट्स वाला क्वेश्चन हाई ऑर्डर थिंकिंग सो दैट यू नो यू कैन गो अहेड यू कैन लर्न सम मोर अपार्ट फ्रॉम योर टेक्स्ट बुक एंड आई विल फोकस ऑन टेक्स्ट बुक एज वेल ताकि आपका रिविजन पार्ट अच्छे से चलता रहे फाइन तो चलो शुरू करते हैं हाउ टू लर्न केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एसिड्स एंड बेसिस व्हाट इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट हियर एसिड्स की प्रॉपर्टीज केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज एज वेल एज फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज सो फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू कवर द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एसिड्स एंड आफ्टर दैट वील कम बैक टू बेसिस फाइन Okay, let's learn what exactly is an acid and how it behaves with different substances. Okay, so this is the first thing. As I told you, we will start our session with the very important and very conceptual based question. By the end of this session, you are going to know what exactly is the strongest acid in the whole world. Okay, and it is going to be super interested to know that. Agar aap chahte ho, we will always come back with, you know, so many important things to learn. So please like, share and subscribe our channel. Right now, like it so that we can come ahead with so many, you know, conceptual things to you. Okay. So this, by the end of the session, you are definitely going to know that. Stay with me till the end. This is going to be super awesome session. Okay. First thing, let's just know what exactly is an acid, which you have learned in your textbook. Acid wo hai, which generally donates H positive ions in water. Correct. Yahi padha hai textbook mein. Jo एसिड पानी में डालते ही एच पॉजिटिव आयंस को रिलीज कर दे दिस इज सिंपल डेफिनेशन व्हिच इज गिवन बाय अ साइंटिस्ट व्हिच इज नोन एज अरेनियस ओके सो वी कॉल इट अरेनियस एसिड थ्योरी क्लियर सो लेट्स स्टिक टू दैट पार्ट ओनली टिल द एंड वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न सम मोर इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग अबाउट एसिड एज वेल अभी उसी थ्योरी से लेट जस्ट स्टार्ट सम केमिकल रिएक्शन व्हाट बेसिकली दिस इज रिएक्शन ऑफ एसिड विद मेटल्स All of you know what exactly is a metal, right? Metal is something which is electropositive in nature, which can donate its electron. And whenever you put it into an acid, let's just see what exactly will going to happen. Okay? So let's know it right now. I have taken a pen. So chalo, shuru karte hain. Kaun sa metal le? Let's just go by this activity which I have put already. And you have seen there is magnesium pieces. So, humne kya kiya? I have taken magnesium, okay, magnesium pieces, and I put it into an acid that is dilute hydrochloric acid. Okay, all of you know the formula of dilute HCl. So, magnesium, which is a metal, I put it into HCl that is diluted. All of you already know, right? What is the meaning of dilute? That means by putting water, we have made its concentration. Comparatively less, okay? Less concentrated solution and more of water. Fine? So, whenever these two things react with each other, if I talk in general terms, whenever metal reacts with acid, what exactly is going to happen? Metal plus acid always form metal salt. Why? As I told you, metal is electropositive. Positive charge will come. So that will attach to negative part. And whenever positive and negative attach with each other, what kind of a substance is formed? Okay, that substance is known as salt. Okay, bacha? So that is salt, which is going to form MgCl2, magnesium chloride. And what will happen to this hydrogen? Hydrogen can't exist in H form, na? So in form of H2 gas, it is going to evolve out. So can anyone tell me what exactly will be the state of this MgCl2? Just like this is solid, this is dilute. What exactly will be the state of MgCl2? Please tell me the answer in the chat box. I will definitely going to answer that what exactly is the correct answer. Okay? So this you are going to tell me. Fine? Salt, which is magnesium chloride. Kaise balance karenge? 2 chlorine. So what I am doing right now? Let's put it 2 here. So that is MgCl2 and hydrogen gas. Reaction is balanced, right? So hua kya reaction mein? You have taken the magnesium, metal, put it into acid, which is attached to a delivery tube. Okay, hollow tube hai ye, and that is connected to a soapy, water soapy solution. What exactly will happen? Hydrogen gas is very light as compared to, this water and bubbles also. So hydrogen gas is going to be trapped in those soap bubbles. Bubbles will rise and containing hydrogen gas. Kaise pehchanoge hydrogen gas ko? All of you know the answer that, ma'am, yes, there is a sound known as pop sound. So pop sound aya, matlab hydrogen gas hai. But bacha log, what exactly is that pop sound? Pop sound means whenever you take a burning candle, burning matchstick near it, to wo kya karta hai? Hydrogen gas in the presence of air combust. Okay, combust matlab burn ho jati hai in presence of air, and whenever it is reacting and showing combustion, to chhota sa explosion hota hai. So pop sound is nothing but a small explosion. Okay, small explosion. So this is going to be an interactive session. As I told you, this is clear to you how metal reacts with acid, always gives salt and hydrogen gas. Okay, now second thing which I really want to ask from you, all metals behave the same way with the acid. Suppose I've taken a particular acid, HCl. Okay, fine. So kya HCl har metal ke saath same tarike se behave kar raha hai? My second question is this from all of you. So jaldi se just tell me what could be the response of this question. On this note, I am helping you out right now to tell you what exactly which I have said. Kya bola tha? Every metal behaves the same way with all of the acid. So it's not true. All of you know the reactivity series of metals, that all metals does not behave the same way with everything, that is acid or air or water, etc. So in this example, I have taken an aluminium metal, piece of aluminium metal, and I put in the same acid, that is HCl, hydrochloric acid. What new you are seeing right here? Kya dekh rahe ho aisa naya? That whenever you are putting into an acid, it starts floating on the surface. Now just think, you are putting a metal into acid and it starts floating. What could be the reason? Third question, third objective we are going to learn today. What do you think? Please tell me in the chat box, and I am helping you as well. Kya ho sakta hai? So whenever this aluminium, as you see here, is reacting with HCl, what is going to happen? It is written here as well. Kya bana raha hai? Same metal salt, aqueous form. So metal salt, that is AlCl3, again hydrogen gas is going to form. But what is new here in this question as compared to that? That aluminium is floating because from its surface, see it clearly, from its surface some bubbles are coming out. किसके बबल्स हैं? ऑब्वियसली गैस, गैस के बबल्स होंगे. सो हाइड्रोजन गैस के बबल्स स्टार्ट्स कमिंग आउट फ्रॉम द सर्फेस ऑफ एल्यूमिनियम बिकॉज एल्यूमिनियम इज रिएक्टिंग विद द एसिड एंड मेक सॉल्ट एंड हाइड्रोजन गैस. हाइड्रोजन गैस निकल रहा है आसपास से, गैस है, लाइट गैस है, विल मेक द एल्यूमिनियम पीस लाइटर. एल्यूमिनियम पीस विल बिकम लाइटर नाउ, दैट मीन्स इट स्टार्ट्स फ्लोटिंग ऑन द वॉटर. Is this concept clear? Similar question can ask even in the third chapter. Some of you were asking me कि मैम metals, non-metals का भी कुछ कराओ. So I've covered one concept also. Some of the metal when put it into acid can float on the surface. So this could be the exact answer. So that is related to acid as well as metal. I hope this concept is clear to you. So all of the new students, I hope you like it. A new concept you have learned. So please like and subscribe our channel. On this note, let's move ahead to learn some more concept about acid only. What exactly is this thing? Please, zara padhiye isko. Acids with metal carbonate. Now, what exactly is an acid and how it behave with metal carbonate? So, all of you know what exactly is metal carbonate. Metal with CO3 group. CO3 group ke saath metal carbonate is formed. And how exactly they behave? Let's just see it in this activity only. So, we have taken acid and then marble chips. How marble chips is related to metal carbonate? Can anyone tell me? Yes, some of you already have the answer that ma'am, marble chips is made up of calcium carbonate only. So don't have any confusion in this. This is marble chips only. This type of a question can come in the exam. When marble chips react with acid, what is going to happen? Okay, so this is the third objective. Let's just know what will happen. So whenever you take metal carbonate, I have taken a particular metal carbonate, that is calcium carbonate, which is what? Marble chips. So calcium carbonate reacts with acid. I have taken the same acid, HCl, okay, hydrochloric acid. Kya banega? Kya lagta hai? One important thing I'm telling you right now, whenever you see this CO3 group, carbonate group, to kya karna hai? Whenever you put it into an acid, CO2 gas is going to be released for sure. Okay, metal carbonate acid ke saath react karega, one of the product must be CO2. Rest, what can happen? Metals are electropositive, so combined with the negative part of this, so salt formation will also be there. To kya banega? General term mein what you can write, ma'am, salt banega. And then as you told, CO2 and one oxygen is left with some hydrogen. So water is also going to form. Okay, so tell me what is the salt which has formed right here? Calcium with chlorine. Kaun sa salt banega? Calcium chloride, absolutely true. To balance the reaction, I can put 2 as well. So what we are going to write? Calcium chloride plus CO2 gas and H2O, that is water. Fine, dekho jadoo bhi ho raha hai yahan pe. So you can see in this activity as well, as you took marble chips and put dilute acid into it, what you are seeing in the delivery tube, something is going into this test tube, that is CO2, carbon dioxide gas. Carbon dioxide gas jaise hi solution mein milegi, what kind of a solution I have taken? Lime water. This also you know, or just tell me what will going to happen. Lime water, whenever you pass CO2 gas from lime water, kya banega? Kya banega? It will turn milky. But what would be the reaction? Again, a new objective you are going to learn. Lime water is having this formula. Calcium hydroxide. Okay, aqueous solution of calcium hydroxide you have taken and you have passed CO2 gas from it. So this is, you can also tell that this is a test for CO2 gas. You can check what exactly CO2 gas does or kaise pehchanoge CO2 gas nikli hai. What is going to form? Again, this product, calcium carbonate. Kaise? Calcium with CO2 and some oxygen, calcium carbonate and then some water. So why this lime water turns milky? Because this is going to form calcium carbonate which has white precipitate which make the solution milky. Okay, so because of this thing you are getting the milky appearance. Okay, so because of this you are getting a milky appearance. This concept is also clear to you. So metal with carbonate, salt, CO2 and water. One question, again a new question, I really want to ask from all of you, what about this case? Metal carbonate and metal bicarbonate mein, is there any difference or they both behave in the same way with the acid? Kya lagta hai? What could be the answer? Yes or no? Please tell me in the chat box. Okay, you know the answer. I can see that. Ke metal carbonate, bicarbonate products are almost same. Kaise? Yahan bhi salt ban raha hai. And then CO2 and water as I told you. Reaction is almost same. It's just the number of molecules. Okay? Nothing is going to change. It's just the number of molecules of acid you are taking in that carbonate wala case and bicarbonate wala case. That could vary. But products formation is going to be the same way. That is salt, water and CO2 gas. So what is exactly forming here? You can see that. Yes, so this is a salt and this is water and this is carbon dioxide gas. Carbon dioxide gas. Now, can you all tell me why I put this GIF right there? Koi to reason hai, hai na? What could be the reason? Again, a new concept you are going to learn, that where we can use this reaction, where metal carbonate reacting with acid we can use in our day-to-day life. So here I have taken a particular bicarbonate, that is sodium bicarbonate, and I am reacting with an acid, that is sulfuric acid. Kaun sa hai ye? Sodium bicarbonate, it has a particular name as well, common name. What is that common name? Baking soda. Okay, which is a bicarbonate only. So this bicarbonate we can use with this acid, that is dilute sulfuric acid, to give what? Again a salt, which is sodium sulfate. I hope you get it. How we get sodium sulfate? Sodium with sulfate, positive with negative part of this. Sodium sulfate, water and CO2 gas. So what exactly is going to happen in this fire extinguisher? You are getting aqueous solution with water of the sodium sulfate and CO2 gas is also there. So ek foam type ka structure bana leta hai. So together they'll make a foam, thick foam. What exactly with this thick foam will do? This has CO2 gas into it. So whenever there is fire, when you put pressure onto it, this is going to release and that will extinguish the fire. Kyunki CO2 kya karta hai? CO2 can extinguish the fire. So we can use this, this is kind of an application in day-to-day life. This is clear to you? Very good. On this note, let's just move ahead to learn some more concept. Third concept. What is that? That means new reaction acid with base that you are going to know, or I should say that you have already known even from 7th class. There was a chapter, acid basis salt, that whenever acid reacts with the base, always, you can see on the screen as well. Kya ho raha hai? Yes, we all know neutralization. So acid combines with base to give a neutralized product, that is salt and water will also be there. So ab mujhe ye batao aap sab, why this neutralization is going to happen? Why? Because acid has H positive ion, base has OH negative ions. They will combine water and the rest thing will make salt, okay, which can be neutral. So kaise hoga? Let's just see that part also, how you do it in terms of chemistry. Kaun sa acid? Jo bhi lena chaho. Suppose I have taken HCl, aqueous solution of HCl with NaOH, aqueous solution of NaOH. So always remember, you are taking two aqueous solution, one is acid, one is base, you are combining it. And what product you are getting? As I told you, H positive, OH negative will give you water. Na positive with Cl, NaCl, common salt which we all use in our day-to-day life. Okay? Common salt which we use in our day-to-day life. Apart from that, we are getting water as well. Is this clear to you? How neutralization is going to happen? Salt, water is going to form. Okay? Clear? Okay, one part of acid reaction is also done. तो एसिड कैसे रिएक्ट करता है विद मेटल, विद कार्बोनेट्स, मेटल कार्बोनेट्स, विद मेटल बाइकार्बोनेट्स, विद बेसिस, रिवर्स कैन ऑल्सो बी ट्रू, बेस विद एसिड, सेम काइंड ऑफ अ रिएक्शन ओनली. दिस इज क्लियर टू यू? येस. सो प्लीज लाइक आवर वीडियो सो दैट वी कैन कम विद सो मेनी मोर इंटरेस्टिंग कंटेंट्स. ओके, लेट्स नो. एज आई टोल्ड यू, फोर्थ टाइप ऑफ अ रिएक्शन राइट नाउ, reaction of acids with metal oxide. Can anyone tell me what exactly is the nature of metal oxide? Okay, most of you know that. Yes, metal oxide. Acha, either it is metal oxide, metal carbonate, metal bicarbonate, metal hydroxide. All of them are generally bases only. Okay, metal ke jitne bhi form hai, ye base banate hain. So now this is clear that in a way, you know that whenever acid react with base, salt and water is going to form. Okay, so same reaction is going to happen over there as well. Kya ho raha hai? Acid, I have taken a particular example as well, HCl, is reacting with copper oxide. See, copper oxide is black in color. Okay, black color ka powder type ka substance hai. Basic, metal oxide is basic. So, you know, whenever acid and base reacts with each other, salt and water is going to form. Kaun sa salt banega here? Just see, copper, positive, metal with negative part, copper chloride, blue-green color, and then water is going to form. Okay, color bhi change ho gaya. You have taken a black solution because there is water as well. HCl mein dala hai tumne. Black color ka solution hai. After some time, the color changes to blue-green because a new substance is going to form. That is salt and water. This part is also clear to you. Whenever metal oxide react with acid, you will always get salt and water. So most of the property, chemical properties of acids are done. We have one more part. What exactly is that part? Some of you, or I should say most of you, know that. But what exactly is the reason that we say the statement that acids are corrosive in nature? So acids corrosive kaise in nature mein? What does that term mean, corrosive? Corrosive means corrosion, you already know that, right? So corrosion or corrosive means whenever you put it into any surface, either it would be a metal surface or even on your body, what will happen? They will damage it, they will degrade the upper layer of it. So you know, whenever you take metal, metal pe agar acid daloge, upper layer can get degraded. If that is very strong acid, that metal can, you know, convert into molten form as well. Okay, aqua regia, if you try to remember that, acid ka solution hi hai. You took gold and put it into it, the gold metal is going to dissolve into it. So it is depend completely upon the strength of that acid. Acids are corrosive in nature. Even if you put on your hand by mistake in the laboratory, you can see the charred skin because it can absorb water from your skin as well. So that is why most of the time, if you have visited your laboratory, some of the apparatus which is already, you know, written and that is having some acid, this symbol they have used very commonly. What exactly this mean? That substance is corrosive in nature. If you put on your hand or, you know, any metal, the surface can be degraded, you can be hurt, or, you know, the substance can be corroded. Now this concept is also clear that why acids are corrosive in nature. Done. So let's come to know the final conclusion. As I told you, in the end, we are going to know a new concept and we are going to solve that Hodge question. Okay, so what exactly is this theory? All of you know what is this Arrhenius theory of acid, because that is the part of 10th class, that whenever you take an acid, acid will be acid only when you put it into water and that will release H positive aqueous ion. Aqueous term is very much important. Why? Aqueous means you have put it into water and water molecules will, you know, gathered around it. So basically, if you take HCl, if you put it into water, H positive aqueous ions, and we have discussed in our midterm as well, we can also write it H3O positive ions. That is hydronium ion, because aqueous means they are gathered with H2O molecule and this is going to form then. Correct? You can see it. Hydronium ion. This is the concept. You already know. What is Arrhenius acid? I am going to tell you one more concept, that is Lewis theory of acid. What exactly is Lewis theory of acid? As the name suggests, that was given by a scientist, N. Lewis. So Lewis ne kya suggest kiya? Some of you have that idea, Lewis dot structure theory, in the third chapter, metals and nonmetals. Here Lewis gave one more concept. Lewis said that even that is not the only concept. An acid can also behave as Lewis acid when it can accept electron pair. Electron ka pair, whenever an element can accept, that is also an acid. Now how that come, you know, true? Because certain substances have vacant space in between their orbit, or we also have one more name, orbitals. So they have some vacant space in between their orbit and orbitals. Electrons can come and take part, can take that position. So whenever the element has that space, that can be taken by electron pair. Jab bhi usko zarurat hogi, wo le lega. Aur agar aisa ho gaya, that means that substance is also an acid. New concept, Lewis acid. Now you will be like, ma'am, what example you can give about that? See, BF3, boron trifluoride, antimony pentafluoride. Okay, SB is a symbol for antimony. Okay, how this boron trifluoride is a Lewis acid? All of you know that boron has 5 atomic number, correct? So you can write its configuration as 2 and 3, correct? So 3 valence electrons are there in its last shell. So it has space so that it can gather some more electron into it. 8 means stability. Somehow, ye kuch electrons ko accept bhi kar sakta hai. So that is a Lewis acid. Same with SBF5. Now you know what exactly is a Lewis acid also. You know what is Arrhenius acid. So you have learned some more concept as well. Why I'm telling you and why this is going to help you out in this. What exactly was our question? Strongest acid. Kya dikh raha hai screen pe? What answer I wrote? Super acid. Okay, so we have a super name, that is super acid. What exactly is super acid? Super acid is something which is made by the mixture of two acid. So as the name suggests, ye aisa acid hai which is stronger than, you know, pure sulfuric acid. Abhi tak aapko yehi tha, that notion in your mind, that sulfuric acid was the strongest one. To aisa bilkul nahi hai. That is more stronger than the pure sulfuric acid. How? It is made by the combination of two acid, which I've already told you in the previous slide. One is Arrhenius acid, one is Lewis acid. So the mixture of this will give you a super acid, which is very much stronger to you. Kaise? This is the example which on your screen, super important, HSBF6. What is the name? The name is fluoroantimonic acid. कैसे बना है ये? Let's just know right now. This is made by HF, which I already told you, Arrhenius acid, release H positive ions, plus SBF5, which I have already told you in the previous slide. तो ये एक Arrhenius acid, AA, for a time being I'm writing that. This is Lewis acid, LA. ठीक है? Whenever you combine these two acid, what is going to form? Combine कर दो जरा इसको. H, why H पहले? Acid है. H first से start करोगे. Then the combine whole thing. SBF6. So this acid has a particular name, fluoroantimonic acid. Fluoroantimonic acid. Very much stronger. Why very much stronger? Even if you take a stainless steel ka spoon and you put it into that solution, what is going to happen? Magic. Chemistry magic. Thodi der baad spoon will be vanished. Okay? So that is going to happen. But it is very much corrosive. Very much corrosive. Very difficult to handle. Okay? So hum to nahi karne wale hain. Hai na? So this is the truth. Now you will be like, ma'am, क्या सिग्निफिकेंस है? सो बहुत सारी केमिकल रिएक्शन में दिस एसिड एक्ट एज अ कैटलिस्ट व्हिच मेक्स द रिएक्शन वेरी मच फास्टर. ओके, सो देयर आर सर्टेन सिग्निफिकेंस एज वेल. क्लियर? नाउ ऑल ऑफ यू कैन प्राउडली से वी नो व्हाट एग्जैक्टली सुपर एसिड एंड व्हाट इज द यू नो वर्ल्ड्स मोस्ट स्ट्रांग सुपर एसिड इज. इज दिस कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर टू यू? सो न्यू स्टूडेंट्स, क्या करना है आपको? Please subscribe and like our video, and next time also I'll come up with some more questions. Super interesting question. On this note, we are feeling relaxed that most of the part is done. तो थोड़ा काम आपके लिए भी. व्हाट वर्क आई एम गिविंग यू, एसिड्स का मोस्ट ऑफ द पार्ट वी हैव डन. बेसिस रिएक्ट्स ऑलमोस्ट साइमल्टेनियसली एज लाइक एसिड. सो देयर इज अ क्वेश्चन फॉर यू, हाउ बेसिस रिएक्ट्स विद नॉन मेटल ऑक्साइड्स. वी हैव सीन हाउ acid reacts with the metal oxide, simultaneously base reacts with non-metal oxides. So you need to tell me how they react and what kind of product they form, and you have to write the equation as well. I'll be waiting for your response, and in the next class I will take the first person's name who is going to reply me on, you know, number one. Okay, is this clear to you? To pakka se karna hai. On this note, work is done, but if you still have any doubt, please go to our doubt solving app, download it, and you are never going to disappoint, because we always come up with so many new things. And you can download the sessions PDF as well. Apart from that, we are on Telegram as well, so you can chat with your teachers. So download it and stay in touch with us. And on this note, what I have for all of you, thank you so much. Please like, share and subscribe. If you still have any doubt regarding what we have done, please reach out to me. This is my email ID, anubha.gaur@vedantu.com. I really enjoyed this session. I've tried my best to teach you, you know, new things as well. So please do it. On this note, thank you so much. Good evening to all of you. Take care and all the very best for your midterm exams. Bye-bye.